My name is Tim Cronin. I just started here earlier this month as an assistant professor. I'm really excited to be here. I was a grad student here for 5 years and then did my postdoc at Harvard. Now I'm back. I'm interested in modeling the atmosphere and atmosphere-land interactions, especially stuff related to clouds and land. I've recently been really excited by the process of formation of cold air. So this is something that's really important for climate change, because we expect that the coldest air masses to warm up more quickly than the rest of the world, and particularly something known as Arctic amplification, where the Arctic warms more than the rest of the world, especially the tropics. So what I've been doing is studying in a very simplified way what happens when air that starts out over the ocean at high latitudes moves over land or sea ice during wintertime and cools off really dramatically. And what I've found using simplified models is that this process slows down in a warmer climate. So you get more clouds that form at low levels in the atmosphere starting from a warmer initial air mass, and it cools off less at the surface than it does in the current climate. So this is a potential way to understand why cold air masses warm up more with climate change than parts of the rest of the world. So I ended up in EAPS because after college, when I majored in physics, I decided I was interested in doing something that seemed a little more applied to the real world. And so I joined up with a lab in Woods Hole that did terrestrial ecosystem modeling. And they collaborated with people here at MIT, both in the joint program on the science and policy of global change and also in EAPS. And so I got connected with those people, and after a few years working in research, decided that the grad program in EAPS seemed like a good fit for me. And so I came back to grad school and got my PhD here, then went for a postdoc for a few years at Harvard. Now I'm back as an assistant professor. On a day-to-day basis, so a lot of what I do is either pencil and paper theory, writing down equations and trying to figure out how we can approach them with simple computer models, or running more complicated computer models, but with very, very simple boundary conditions. So one example is this problem of cold air formation, where I've basically taken just a full single column model that represents the full complexity of what's used in a full climate model, but taken away all of its coupling with other columns of the atmosphere. And so I'm just looking at what happens to that single column of the atmosphere if you turn off the sun, or equivalently, if you think about moving it from a warm surface underneath to a surface where there's no sunlight in polar winter. That's a good question. How does this compare or relate to what we're doing with global climate model studies? What I think of this as really doing is trying to isolate a mechanism that is present in climate models, but we haven't fully teased apart how it works. And so what I'm trying to do is isolate how this process of cold air formation contributes to changes in the temperature structure in the vertical of the high latitude atmosphere with warming. Many of these aspects of things may be captured by global climate models. There may be some limitations in resolution, and especially limitations in how the models represent clouds that may be different from what I'm modeling. But the basic process should be captured in global models. Yeah, so coming back here as a professor after having been a student has been really great so far. Obviously, I haven't been here very much time, but I feel like I'm very respected and treated as a colleague by the professors. And I know what it's like to be a student, and I feel like that's going to help me relate to students and, you know, do work with the great body of students that we have here.